They say the best camera is the one that you have with you, and for most of us, that is our iPhone. So today, I'm gonna show you guys a few ways to take better photos just using your iPhone. So the first way is to enable the grid on your camera. You don't even need an app or anything for this. You can just go into the settings of your phone, click camera, and then enable grid. In the last video, we talked about using the rule of thirds and how that can make the composition of your photo better. So this is kind of essential if you want to line things up with the rule of thirds. It can also help make your photos more level if you have a hard time doing that. And if you don't know what I'm talking about with the rule of thirds, I will link my last video below if you want to check that out.
So the next one is to use the Pro HDR app on your phone for landscape photos. So iPhones have a built-in HDR, but it's not as good as if you use one of the apps, which are like $2. There's probably some free ones out there too.
So I like to do the manual version on the Pro HDR app. So I'll drag a box to the highest exposure I want to get and the lowest that I want to get. And then you'll have one that's kind of in the middle too. So it'll take both photos and then put them together, and you'll get a much larger dynamic range. As you can see here, can see all the sky, nothing is blown out and white. So this is really good for sunsets, landscapes, or anytime the background is just too bright but you still want to capture the detail.
The one thing you have to be careful about though is staying really, really still. And if you have someone in the photo, they have to stay really still too, because it's taking multiple images. If you move, it's gonna be a little bit blurry.
The next thing is to shoot in a raw file format. So the default format for iPhones is not RAW, I'm pretty sure it's JPEG. But there's a few different apps you can download to change that to RAW. So the one that I use is called Manual Camera. It's like $2 or $3 in the app store, I believe. So if you get this app, you just go into the settings, click on format for the photo, and you'll wanna change it from JPEG to RAW. So if you shoot in this format and you don't like the white balance that the iPhone picked for you, you can change that later when you're editing. You have a lot more options if you shoot in a raw file format.
All right, the next tip, if you're shooting outside and it's really bright out, you'll notice that if you touch the screen of your phone, it'll change the exposure. So you'll notice here when I'm taking a photo, if I click on the house, it's totally gonna just completely blow out the sky. It's like a white blob, we can't really see it. So what you wanna do is touch that part. And I mean, it's the sun, so it's gonna be a little blown out, but have it there and take the photo like this. And then later when we're editing, we can brighten up this part.
So here's another example. As you can see here, outside of the window is way too bright.
So you can see here, if I tap on my bed, then we can't see the windows at all. Like, you can't see anything outside there. But if you click on the window, it's just gonna underexpose the bed a little bit, but we can brighten that up later.
So on the right, we have the underexposed image, and on the left, we have the overexposed image. So to brighten up this one, you can select everything except what's outside the windows and brighten that up. So then we have it brighter inside, and we still have the detail outside. But let's see what happens if we don't underexpose the image and we just try and darken the overexposed part. As you can see, it doesn't really work. The goal would be for it to look how it looks on the photo on the right, but all it does is make things turn gray and black, and it doesn't save any of the detail.
And the last one is just to use the Huji app. If you guys aren't familiar with this app, it pretty much replicates the look of a disposable film camera. So it makes these cool little light leaks and just, I don't know, it just looks really good. You could seriously take a picture of like a pile of garbage and this app will make it look cool.
Ooh, that light leak.
Ooh, that's cool. You guys, seriously, just use Huji. That's like all you need. All right, that is it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed. Comment down below if you have any more tips on taking pictures on an iPhone. And if you see a comment that has a really good tip, like it so that other people can see it. And I'm gonna go and like them and reply to them too. So definitely comment down below. Follow me on Instagram if you haven't already and you wanna see the photos that I take. That is it for this video. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.